Hi, this is Mike from Music Ministry 101 with 20 tips in 20 days for choir directors. Here's tip number 14. Okay, tip number 14 is for the health and the benefit of your entire program, and that is build a youth choir. A lot of music ministers that are just starting out in their current role, they might need some basic help with building a youth choir. So I'd like to share some of my ideas about how to build and start a youth choir at your masses. Now, if you already have a youth choir going, you might not need to watch this tip, so you might want to check out tip number 15. But if you're like some folks I know that are looking to build a youth choir, here's how I would suggest doing it. First of all, it's not as hard as you think, because kids attract other kids. So once you get the first two or three kids, you'll notice that they're like little magnets, and other kids will want to join the youth choir as well, particularly if you're having fun. So getting those first two or three kids is a matter of talking with the kids and especially their parents. The parents are, of course, the driving force behind the entire youth choir operation, and you need to have the parents on your side at all times. Also, don't forget to take your local diocesan youth protection course. Okay, getting back to how to actually do this, well, you'll want to have an initial date where you start your youth choir. And what I would suggest is you're going to begin with quite a low commitment level. Parents these days are actually very incredibly busy, and they don't want another full program usually to commit to. So your youth choir building process is going to be like this, okay? You're probably going to start with a couple kids and then it will grow from there. And the commitment level is the same. Start with low commitment and then you can increase the commitment as you go. So at the very beginning, you could even have your youth choir show up 45 minutes before the mass where they're going to sing. Have them come 45 minutes early, learn and practice one song, maybe two songs, and then have them sing that at the mass. Now, this is a low commitment for parents. Also, the parents feel safe because they get to watch you working with their kids, so there's a safety aspect as well, which is very beneficial, especially when you're first starting. But this is a great way for you to get your two or three kids, and probably a lot more. Now, you're going to want to specify a grade level that you're targeting for. So maybe you decide to do fourth through eighth grade, and that's your youth choir. My youth choir at this point is about fifth grade and up through 12th grade. So you can decide what grade to do. Now, I started with 6th through 12, and then I had some 5th graders come and say, hey, we'd like to join. So I said, sure, come on. So now it's 5th through 12. Next year, it'll probably be 4th through 12 because I have 4th graders that want to join as well. So anyways, what you're going to do is have a date where you start the youth choir, make it a low commitment for parents so that they can kind of test out the waters, okay, before committing to a huge program. And start building smoothly like this. Then, when you have the kids in front of you, you're going to want to do a song that they're going to be very successful at because you want the kids to sound good, okay? Even if they only do one song. So what our kids do in our youth choir is they always sing the communion meditation song every week. So they'll actually sit with their parents during Mass and they'll come up for communion, and then we do the meditation song all together. Now, when do they learn the meditation song? Mostly before Mass, at our before Mass rehearsal. But also, we've had a couple seasonal rehearsals here and there to supplement an entire season. So I might have an Advent rehearsal where we do, you know, the four Sundays of Advent and Christmas, and we rehearse all of that music. Then they come before Mass, and we put the final touches on whatever song we're doing. So that's the current structure of my youth choir. Now, why that's good again is because the low commitment for the parents, the kids do songs that they can feel good about, we do lots of solos, keep it fun, keep it light, and finally, it's just convenient for parents to bring their kids before Mass, watch them rehearse a little bit, do one song at the Mass, great for the community, great for the kids, and then that's it. So I hope you enjoyed this tip. I hope that this helps you start a youth choir at your church. It's really great to have kids singing at your church. So I hope this is part of your program moving ahead, and I hope you enjoyed this tip. See you in the next one. If you are someone that regularly works with amateur singers and you've been enjoying these tips, please click on the link in the description below to check out my Choir Essentials training program. It is an online video training program that will help you to hone your skills as a choir director. Whether you need to recruit more members, get them to sound professional, in tune, with a clear and free tone, or if you need help with working with difficult members or keeping your members happy in general, this program is for you. So I encourage you to click the link in the description below and check it out. And if you found this particular tip to be useful, I'd love to know that you're here and that I should keep producing this content for you. So please smash the like button below as well. If you'd like to build your choir or start one, if you'd like to get your choir sounding professional with perfect harmony, rhythm, and vocal blend, if you'd like to motivate your choir to learn new songs and harmonies without any hassle, I'd like to invite you to try my Choir Essentials training program today. Hi, my name is Michael Carney from Music Ministry 101. Over the past 15 years, I've been able to grow and improve several choir programs in churches and in schools, from just a few members to hundreds more. And during that time, I've had the honor of leading choirs of all ages and sizes into successful performances. As I've become more successful with choir directing, a lot of people started to ask me for tips and advice that they could use to create more success for themselves. I've created a training program that contains the most important things I've learned about growing a choir, getting them to sound great, and running a successful choir program. And you can watch them all now in my Choir Essentials training program. You'll learn everything from my step-by-step approach to recruiting adult and youth choir members, to the best ways to teach harmony without having pushback from your singers, and the quickest and best ways to improve your choir's sound, whether it be an issue of vocal blend, pitch, or rhythm. My ideas and methods have impacted people around the world, and I know I can help you to build the successful choir that you've always wanted to achieve. Just visit me at musicministry101.com and try my Choir Essentials training program today. It is risk-free for 30 days and will guarantee that you will massively improve your choir program. Thanks for checking out my channel.